Every story has a beginning, somewhere in space and time. This one starts in Wales, 1947, with a young tank engine. This engine belongs to a small railway that runs between the docks at Welsham and a town called Carnlow Bridge. The line is only about 6 miles long, and has three engines, a B12 named Stan, an N2 named Gresley, and a young J94 named Timothy. Timothy had recently received a new coat of silver paint. It was a beautiful coat and he wore it with pride. He was assigned to the docks at Welsham with his driver Matt and fireman Rob. He spent most of his time there or at the scrapyard about a mile away. Despite being young and quite cocky at times, he always worked hard. One afternoon, he was shunting at the scrapyard. He didn't like the job, but it had to be done.
Well, come along, Tim. This is the last one for today.
Great. I'm really looking forward to a good night's rest.
So am I.
Done. Now we can finally go home.
Timothy reversed out of the scrapyard, and he was soon back at his shed by the docks.
Good night, Tim.
Good night, guys.
Good night.
After they left, Timothy closed his eyes. The next morning, he woke up only to find that his driver hadn't turned up.
Rob? Where's Matt?
Morning, Tim. I'm sorry to say, but he's in hospital.
Oh? What's wrong with him?
I don't know. I'm going to visit him later today.
Oh, I see. Who's coming to take his place, then?
I don't know. The station master will probably send someone up.
Timothy waited and waited, but nobody came.
I guess it's just you and me then.
I suppose it is. Think you can handle it?
Well, I could try.
No need for that. I'll be Timothy's driver today.
If you say so, Mr. Station Master.
Timothy was soon on his way, shunting trucks into their proper sidings as usual. And it continued in that fashion over the next couple of weeks. Until one day, Rob arrived, looking very sad.
Morning. What seems to be the matter?
Well, Timothy, I'm sorry to tell you this. I truly am. But Matt has passed away. He left a message for you, though.
Oh?
I'll read it to you.
Dear Timothy, now you must be wondering what this fiasco is all about. Well, let me tell you. I was proven positive for brain cancer. I do apologize for not telling you this before, but that's how it is. Now your fireman, Rob, will probably be taking over my position as your driver. I know he'll look after you. One day we'll meet again, I promise. Until then, you must prove to everyone that you're going to be a great shunter, as I always knew you would be. Goodbye, Timothy.
That's beautiful. Don't worry, driver. I'll be a great shunter.
Come on, we'd better get started.
Just then, they saw a man walking towards them.
Hello, Beat's the name. And you must be Timothy, right?
I am.
Hi, I'm Rob.
Ah, so you're Rob. Station Master mentioned that I'll be working with you.
With his new crew on board, they set to work. He had a feeling that he'd like Pete. He seemed kind and friendly. Timothy worked harder than ever, long into the night and into the early morning. It was no surprise that he often overslept. But when he did wake up one day, the Station Master came to the shed.
Get yourself some sleep, Timothy. You worked hard enough yesterday. I've made a few changes to the timetable. Gresley will take over your work during the day, and you'll be on the night trains.
Oh, all right, sir. If you say so.
Just then, Gresley the N2 backed up on the next track, looking very annoyed.
You're not meant to work so late.
Well, there was a lot of scrap at the yard that needed to be sorted out.
You haven't got the faintest idea how much of a pain this is. You've dropped me right in it.
What did I do?
You've worked for too long. Now I can't keep to schedule.
It's not my fault, is it?
Well, if you just...
Gresley, what's going on here?
I have to do this twat's work while he gets a rest. It's nearly a double shift.
Look, you're here to obey orders, so shut up and get on with it.
But you... Fine.
Thank you, Stan.
Oh, be quiet. I wouldn't even have to quiet him down if it wasn't for you.
What did I do?
As Gresley just said, you've worked too long for your own good. Keep to the timetable next time.
Huh.
Timothy spent the rest of the day in his shed. Soon, evening came, and the austerity was soon ready to take Gresley's evening passenger train when Stan unexpectedly backed onto him.
What's this?
We're double-heading this train. I can't trust you on this one.
Oi!
Come on, Dan. We'll be late.
And they set off. The journey went well. It was a stopping train and the time dragged on, but eventually they reached the second to last station.
Don't worry, Tim. Just one more stop.
If you say so.
About 2 miles on, they saw the last station. Both engines applied their brakes, but nothing happened. Stan's brakes were all right, but Timothy's weren't. His wheels spun and spun, and the train carried on. Timothy's driver tried to turn off his regulator, but he couldn't. It was jammed wide open, and so was his reverser.
Stan! My brakes have failed, and my reverser regulator are jammed open!
What?
Rob! Decouple the coaches and jump quickly!
But Timothy?
Just do it!
You two should jump as well. All right, Stan.
The coaches were decoupled, and the crews jumped, but the two engines charged on. Stan soon saw the end of the line.
Well, this is it. See you on the other side, boy.
See you on the other side.
What remained of the engines was sent to the yard to be checked over.
You'll be staying with us, Tim. Nothing we can't fix. Although, Stan, I'm sorry, but because you were leading, you took the brunt of the impact.
I understand, sir.
I'm sorry, Stan, but you know what this means.
I know, sir. Thanks for your help.
The two engines watched as the station master walked away. Then Stan turned to Timothy.
Your crew should have checked you over when they arrived, but it didn't. I served my country for a very long time. You know, it's ironic, isn't it? You were only built 3 years ago, Tim, and yet your brakes have failed. I'm in my 40s and still going strong. I could do so much more, but this is what I get. This is my reward. I'll see you soon, Timothy.
Timothy didn't know what to say. He was shocked. The next day, he was taken to the works to be repaired, and then he was sold back to the Northeastern. The following year, he received a new owner, British Railways, and a new number. He kept on working without fuss, and he always made sure that his crew checked him over every morning. He never forgot Stan and his final words.
I could do so much more, but this is what I get. This is my reward.
Despite the accident and the guilt he held for his part in it, He often recalled his old driver's farewell letter.
One day we'll meet again, I promise. Until then, you must prove to everyone that you're going to be a great shunter, as I always knew you would be. Goodbye, Timothy.
Timothy always tried to be a great shunter, to make his driver proud, wherever he was. In 1962, Timothy was withdrawn from service.
Stan didn't deserve what he got. It was all my fault. He deserved so much better. Something tells me my time is coming.
Timothy closed his eyes. Suddenly, he heard a familiar whistle. When he opened them, there stood in front of him was a northeastern engine, still in its prime.
No, no, it can't be you.
It is me, Timothy. I'm here because I want to tell you that this is not the end for you.
It isn't?
Look around you. There's no other engine. Some have passed on. Some have found new homes. You've forgotten. But don't worry. One day, a man will come. He will bring you to his railway. There, you'll find new friends and new adventures.
Really?
Yes. Now go to sleep. You're tired. You don't have to worry anymore.
But Stan, I'm so sorry about what happened.
Don't worry, young engine. Just go to sleep, and we'll soon meet again.
Timothy slowly started to fall asleep. When he remembered...
Stan!
But there was no other engine around. Timothy wondered, was he dreaming, or did he really meet the ghost of his old friend? He then closed his eyes again, but this time he fell into a deep sleep. 20 years had passed, until one morning, Timothy woke up to find a group of men with steel cutters in their hands, slowly approaching.
No, Stan was wrong. It can't be. You said I'd be preserved.
Just then, Timothy heard a voice in the distance.
Oi!
The men stopped. There, a few yards away, was a man in a brown suit.
I've just purchased this engine. I'll take it from here.
The men grunted and went away, and the man from the distance approached Timothy.
Hello, my dear engine. My name is Edwin Salmon. I'm the official manager of the Woodhead line. Me and a few other people decided to reopen it as a heritage line for the benefit of the public.
The name's Timothy, sir.
Nice to meet you, Timothy. I've just ordered a diesel to collect you and deliver you to Sheffield.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. Salmon then walked away.
What did I tell you?
You were right, Stan. Thank you.
No problem. I have to go now. But we'll meet again.
Goodbye.
Soon after, the diesel arrived to take Timothy to the works.
Whoa. That was a good story.
Aye, I doubled that.
Anyway, good night, everyone.
Good night. I served my country long enough. And no, that was not what I deserved. This was...